down there with AB Boxing News. I'm here with Errol Newman Jr. What's going on, man? How's everything?
Everything's going on good, man. Just finished a hard day of training today. You know, we're just here now.
Tell us about the sparring, man. You were sparring like 3-4 different guys, man. How confident are you going to the fight, September 19th?
Next week, Tuesday, September 19th, you know, I'll go against Paul Parker. And, you know, I'd say it's like my last day of sparring. And, you know, just push it today, the 10 hard rounds, back to back to back with different fresh people, you know. And, you know, it's all about pushing yourself at the end of the day. But I'm very confident. I'm ready for whatever comes my way that night. I'm ready for pressure. I'm ready for boxing, you know, whatever he brings to the table, I'm gonna neutralize him and come out on top.
What do you know about Paul Parker?
I know that he's a tall guy. I think he's taller than me. He has a decent right hand, but other than that, it's nothing I haven't seen before.
Nothing you ever seen before?
Nothing I haven't seen before.
Wow, talking about your division, light heavyweight.
Yeah.
Sergey Kovalev is supposed to return to the ring in November. Madison Square Garden against, what was his name?
Shabransky.
Shabransky.
Yeah.
You know, you're familiar with both those guys. Break down that fight. Who wins? And
honestly speaking, before the whole Ward fight, I would say, you know, Kovalev hands down. But we got to see where he's at mentally after, you know, taking a stoppage like this. After he's talking all his bravado, he's gonna end his career. You know, like, we got to see where Kovalev's mindset is at. Shabransky's a tough, young, hungry lion. He came off a loss with Sullivan Barrera, but he's still young. He's still there within the top 15. And this will be his chance for redemption against a former world champion who everybody was scared of.
Will he use the same game plan as Andre Ward in terms of hit him in the body, where we've seen now that Sergey Kovalev is very uncomfortable in that position?
Honestly speaking, you know, you have to go where the danger is. He has to get past Kovalev's power. But if Shabransky's able to do it, he has enough power to, you know, break him down and get the eventual stoppage.
Even for this fight, you know, you had two fights scheduled, they got canceled, and now hopefully third time's the charm now. So,
right.
How frustrating would it be for you not to get, you know, the fight to happen this time around?
You know, like, you know, positive energy, positive thinking, positive results, and I'm not thinking about that. I'm just here to do my job, which is to get ready to train. And, you know, things happen in the sport of boxing. You know, things are unpredictable, but my job is to get ready, and I'm ready, you know? So whatever comes my way, I'll be there.
You was there at the Julian Sosa fight at the Real Deal promotion card Saturday night.
Great card.
Did you get the chance to see the Julian Sosa fight?
I came a little late, you know, came at the tail end of it, but Julian was ripping good combinations. He looked really well against a very seasoned veteran, and I'm very happy for the little brother, man. He did very well for his 10th fight.
Let's talk about some upcoming fights. Erickson the Hammer Lubin versus Jermell Ironman Charlo for the 154 WBC title, man. Break it down.
Man, that's not an easy fight, you know. I'm going to go with my boy Lubin. Me and Lubin's cool. And, like, you know, I feel like, you know, he probably could edge out the fight, but it's not going to be easy. You know, Charlo, he's a lion, you know, lions only, you know.
Yeah.
So he easily can, you know, edge it out. But I don't think that fight will go to a decision, to be honest.
No,
I think that
wow.
fight will... Somebody's ending up on their back, you know? So, but I'm gonna edge off for Lubin on this one.
Even for Lubin, most of his fights, he's always showboating, letting his hands go. Do you think he could afford to do that against Charlo?
Definitely not.
Definitely not?
Definitely not. You know, this is a different type of person that he's been inside there with. And, you know, he's had a great amateur pedigree, but the professional ranks are different. Charlo, he does have a little power. He has more experience, you know, at the professional level. And, you know, you can never count a world champion out, so definitely it's not going to be an easy task.
Charlo has explained in the past interviews that he felt like he should have got a title shot at 21, which Lubin's right now 21. Mm-hmm. You know, he should have been a champion right now rather than 26, 27. Do you feel like Charlo's kind of jealous about that? Or
I mean, like, everybody has their own path to the world title, to greens. Everybody has their own path. So me personally, I would say don't look at somebody else's path compared to yours. All the challenges that he's went through in order for him to become a world champion, those helped mold him to that point. So, you know, maybe he should count his blessings in order to, like, in you know, in opposed to looking at Lubin, who's, you know, on a fast track. Maybe the fast track is what could derail Lubin. Who knows? You know, slow and steady wins the race sometimes.
What about Jerry Hurd versus Austin No Doubt Trout?
Man, Trout is a problem, man. He's a veteran, former world champion, and he's still hungry. He's here to prove something that he's to become a two-time world champion.
Of course.
And you know, Jerry Hurd, he calls the belt sunshine. So, you know, I like that. That was very clever of him. You know what I'm saying? But you know, I think, you know, the young, hungry, you know, Jerry Hurd is going to edge out this win, maybe by stoppage. he might be the first to stop Austin Trout, and that would be a very great feat right there.
Another possible fight that might happen is Deontay Wilder versus Luis Ortiz. Wow, man. Is that a 50-50 fight for you?
50-50 for me, man.
What?
You know, because technically, you know, King Kong, he's better to me. He's better to me than Wilder. But Wilder, man, the Alabama power.
Some serious,
you know, that's
power.
The equalizer, man. What is it? 38 fights, 37 knockouts.
Yes.
That's freaking ridiculous. You know, you can never count out a puncher, man. And like, you know, that's 50-50. It depends on who lands first. You know, the sharper punches of Luis Ortiz or that hellacious crack by Wilder. We'll find out.
How excited would you be if we have a potential matchup between Danny Swift Garcia versus Brandon Bam Bam Rios?
Oh man, that's gonna be a barn burner. But I, DSG hands down for that one. You know, he's a sharper boxer, more fresh. He's taking less punishment, of course, than Brandon Rios. Brandon Rios is a warrior, man. He's always come down to, he always comes to fight, balls to the wall. You know, like, I love Bam Bam, man. But you know, DSG, you know, by decision.
Right now, recently, news has been trending about Adrian Broner's recent altercation, knocking out a random dude. You know, what's the advice as a fighter that you could give to AB to bounce back and, you know, escape that trouble that he has?
I mean, he's having troubles inside the ring, outside the ring, but, like, you know, I would advise him to get some serious counseling, man, because, you know, he's in an emotional roller coaster, you know, like, you know, there's no excuse for that. It doesn't matter what happened and transpired in that situation. What's right there on the camera feed is him running up to the guy and two-piecing him, and that's assault. And hopefully, you know, he beat this case, and, like, you know, he needs some counseling, sit down with his family, because that's what's more important, you know.
Of course.
And I wish him the best, man.
Style Neri, AB Boxing News, Errol Newman Juman.
Thank you.
Don't miss out September 19th.
Fox Sports 1, man. Hey.